105.7. For more than 40 years, Cleveland radio listeners have heard the familiar voice of John Lanigan.
And if you put your hand over your heart, Malone, when you say, maybe from now on when you do that.
So in just a few days, Lanigan hangs up his microphone and says goodbye after a career that began here in 1971.
I came here because it was a guy that was leaving named Don Imus, who was very well known. And everybody kind of wanted that job, and they called me about it. I hadn't applied for it, and he flew me up here, and he said, I'll call you back if I decide to use you. And then I got word he was going to call, so I left and went out and had a few drinks because I didn't want to have to decide. I just moved to Dallas. And he called and he said, I'd like you to come to Cleveland and replace Don Imus. So I came to Cleveland.
Not since Alan Freed as a Cleveland disc jockey had as much impact on his listeners and his city.
Cleveland's been very good to me. Yeah, I can't argue with that. It's been a lucrative place to work. It's been a great place to live. It's been a lot of friends, and it's tough to quit and realize you're not going to go do that anymore. But I'm 71 years old. There's a point in your life where you go, as a lot of people have said to me, it's okay to do this. You've worked long enough. So that's what I'll do. I'll go see my kids more, and I'll go to Florida more, and I'll never start another snowblower in my life.
When you do have time and you're thinking of your career, really, Cleveland's embraced you. You've had such great success here. What are you going to miss the most?
Oh, probably the camaraderie of the show in the morning, having them all together and the people you talk to along the way.
And for much of that time, John's radio partner has been Jimmy Malone.
The two of you guys have been together a long time.
25 years.
Has it been that long?
Yeah, a little bit longer than that.
If I'd have been in prison, I'd be getting out now.
John found his radio partner on stage at the old Cleveland Comedy Club.
I walked into a club with Kip Adada one night at the old comedy club downtown. That's probably my first memory. And he's on stage doing his comedy act. He's a very good stand-up. And he's doing the comedy act, and I thought, wow, the kid's pretty good. And so I invited him on the show. It's like, why don't you come up and be on the show? That's when we first got together. And then he showed up like the next week, and somebody said, there's a guy out here who said, you invited him on the show. And I looked down and I went, I don't know, who is that?
That's
who did I invite? And he said, it's Jimmy Malone.
Yeah.
And
he was
like,
a little bit, you know.
Okay, I'd had a few drinks that night.
So with the hours ticking down on his career behind the microphone, John looks forward to that final show Monday morning with mixed feelings.
I do have mixed feelings going into Monday. My kids will be here. My family's coming out from Colorado. And that'll be fun, but they'll be here till Tuesday. It'll be interesting. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, those days will be, it's not a vacation. Usually when we go on vacation, almost anybody who does what we do knows after a week or 10 days, you got to go back. I'm sure it's going to be different to go, I don't have to go back.
And our equal opportunity annoyers, stand by because Mark.
When you guys say goodbye, you wrap things up at 10 o'clock, your last day?
Don't do that to me. I don't know what'll happen. I have no idea. I'm okay with going. I don't have a problem with it. As somebody wrote, he doesn't seem to have any regrets, so he seems to be taking it okay. So we'll see how it goes. I don't know. I don't know that I'm going to cry about it or anything. I don't see that happening. I'll be okay. It's been a long time. It's been fun.
And for more than 40 years, it's been nothing short of magic. Stephanie Schaefer, Fox 8 News.
Yep. That's right. They're getting out of France because France is all screwed up. So they come to London now where they can get a lot better deal. Used to be they were fleeing London to get out of there because the taxes there were so high that they moved out. But now it's the other way around.